brothers and sisters of a sim racing community, welcome to Sim Racing Life. Well, it's week 6 and also the final of the Crest Autosport AMS2 GT1 Championship. Boy, that's a mouthful. 22 cars on the grid and I've qualified in P8. Well, all I can say about the start is there was a lot of fighting for position going on. As I came around the first corner, all I could see was a cloud of smoke. Seeing the car in front go right, I decided to follow him. Coming through the smoke though, I made contact with Raphael, which sent me off track. But I managed to rejoin safely still in P8. However, my car was now damaged. It's not so easy to see in the replay, but my wheel was now about 10 degrees to the left when going in a straight line. But also, I was having trouble downshifting through gears. Coming up to the third corner, and Tech Aid and Fruit Loop went off ahead of me. Now in P6, Chris C was my next target. Two, and I've now got enough heat in my tyres to step up my game. Chris C locked up his tyres briefly going into turn one, which allowed me to make a move on him and take P5. Now it was time to make my ground up on Tim. Frantically looking for an opportunity to get past Tim, to get a little bit of clear road ahead. Second corner, and I managed to take P4 on the inside line. Coming along the top of the hill, he was able to outbrake me and take back P4. Now noticing that Tim goes wide on this next corner, I had a plan to put into action. Should I not pass him before we both arrive there again? Oh, sun was setting and it was time to put my plan into action. Tim went wide on the third corner. I managed to get in close again and was about to make my move on him on the inside line. I couldn't make it stick, so I backed off, hoping to get another go. Time to start really pushing on Tim, because the podium positions were getting further and further away each lap. Regular as clockwork almost, Tim went wide, allowing me to just stop him from taking back the outside line. Knowing he didn't favour the next corner, I attempted a switchback, and yes, I made it stick this time, taking back P4. Now with a clear road ahead, I had to make up 7 seconds on the car ahead. With the damage to my steering and gears though, it was going to be tough. lap 8, and I can just make out the car directly in front is a back marker. But as I needed a goal, I chose him as my focus to get past. It didn't take long though, as he went off track. But now, stuck in the middle of no man's land. Lap 9. And was the three cars ahead of me the leaders? The only way to find out though was to trial and nail every corner. But as the light started to fade, seeing the track ahead became increasingly more difficult each and every lap. Lap 10, and oh my god, is that P3 just ahead? Sadly no, as by the second corner he allowed me to pass. Damn, another back marker. Lap 11, and I could see a couple of glimmers of light coming from the cars ahead, but it didn't feel like I was making up any ground on them. Now plunged into almost darkness, I was beginning to feel very alone. Mm-hmm. 13, and I started seeing lights ahead where I hadn't before. Yes! The next car was now only 5 seconds ahead and making ground. But is it enough? And now any light we had is now completely gone. Yet, with a damaged car, I continued to push on into the darkness.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
Lap 15, and coming round the second corner, oh my god, was that P3? Sadly again, no, it was another back marker. Coming around the next corner, it definitely looked like I was making ground. lap 17, and P3 was now only 3 seconds ahead. Can I do it though, with so little time left? Lap 18, and the final lap. I didn't know it at the time, I was so focused on the car ahead, I just wasn't paying attention. By the third corner, I knew another lap would be all I needed to make a move on P3. Approaching the final corners, I realised it was the end. MKELM was under 2 seconds ahead, but I hadn't a chance. So, congratulations to Lee, Master Flash, and MKELM for first, second, and third, respectively. I finally crossed the line in P4, which gave me enough points to jump to a podium finish at the end of the season. What a result for my first ever league championship in 11 years of sim racing. A massive congratulations to Lee, who took the title and was well deserved. And also to Rocco for coming second. Well, it sounds like the party is underway already, and no doubt will continue through to the sunrise. So, we'll leave you with Mr. Consistent doing donuts. And until the next time, bye-bye.